Hi, welcome to this tutorial on ixcube for Ten. Today we will show how to model a membrane working directly on a DWG file imported from Africa. So this is generally what happens when we're working with files made by other people that don't know really what a FEM analysis. Let's look at this file here, and you can see that it's been well drawn, but it's not good for making a FEM model. You can see here this line goes through, and then we have an arch that goes over here, and this is not good for our purposes, so we'll just fix it right now. So I'll click on this line and I move it up here, and the same for this one. And okay, that's it. Now we go into the CAD tools and use the draw line, and I will draw a line from here to here and another one here, again on the other side, a line here and a line here. So the proposal of this is that we have the regions here are closed by a line, an arch, a line, and an arch, and also this region here will be closed by groove, the two lines and an arch. This is very important when it comes to detect the regions that we want to fill in with the membrane mesh. Let's give a look at this one here now, and we see this escape to clear the command. This groove here goes like this, and it's not good for our purposes. I will draw a small line from the end point to this one here, and from here to this arch, end of this arch here. Now we need a piece of arch that from here connects this line. So we use the tool arch, start, end, and on. So my start point is this one, my end point is this, my on point is any near on the arch. Again, on the other side, end, like that, near. So we have done these two pieces. It's not visible yet, but we will see it in a moment. Again, I need to draw this other one here, like this. And the left side, like that. Okay, escape. Now I can, I can select this curve here. To select this curve, you see we have overlapped elements here. To find the one we want to select, shift click, and moving over the curves, we can see the one we want to delete, this long one, we don't want it anymore. And that's it. Let's give a look at this one here. Again, this one is a long line that goes down. So I will move the endpoint of this line and move it here. And then again, I will move the endpoint of this one and draw a small segment that goes here and goes up there. Okay, so right now what I have done is I have fixed it, the boundary curves of my membranes. So each of these fields bounded by a polyline. So this is a line, this is an arch, a line, and so on. That seems to be simple and clear. Let's save this model. Save us. That's it. So, of course, we are working in NFDM method. So the technique I am going to show is valid only for this method. If we want to use the NFDM method, we have to model in another way. Okay, now what we want to do is we want to fill in these fields with a mesh. Now what happens, I am going to use the tool Sew and Merge. the tool Sort Merge will fill in the selected polylines with a mesh, a triangle mesh. Now, where is my problem? Well, my problem is that this side here, the left side of this membrane, is not visible from top. If we look from at these polylines from the top side, we see that these areas are visible, so the algorithm can easily fill in with a mesh. But looking from this lateral tunnels are not visible from the top. We will call the command two times to do this mesh. To have an idea what we're doing, and I will use the dimension tool from here to here. So this size here is 7 meters. So again, 7 meters. I will recall again the soon merge, and I want a mesh of 25 by 25 centimeters. Click on OK, and so we see that these fields have been filled in with a mesh. Here we have quite ugly mesh. We will see how to fix this later. What I want to do right now is to finish my job filling in these two lateral fields. Since the Sort Merge tool works in the current UCS plane, I need to change my plane to a vertical using vertical by 2 points. I will click here and here. What I do now is we select the boundary curves, these curves here, this one, and my last curve is this one here. So we have selected these, and we recall the tool Sort Merge on these using the same mesh size. That said, the first step is done. We have created the mesh, quite ugly mesh, I must say. Now what we need is the boundary of this mesh. We have the mesh, but we don't have any boundary fan elements. We are going to use now the all mesh boundary. That means it will detect all the boundary points. We can see here that we have the deviation angle is set to 30 degrees. And so with this value, the software detects all these corner points as endpoints for my boundary edges. That's fine. So I just click on apply. And if we go here now to the mesh edges, we see that all the edges of my mesh have been created. Since we are not interested in this moment in the structural behavior of these edges, what I'm going to do now is I set these edges to be beam elements and to be fixed. Material doesn't care because they will not use it. Fixed means that these membranes will be fixed, completely fixed over these edges. In this moment, I'm not really interested. This maybe is not okay. It's not a beam. It's a cable. But later, I will work on that one. So I have just fixed my edges. My membrane. I'm clamping my membrane over the edges. So what we'll do now? Well, the mesh is quite ugly. What I want is to make a nice uniform mesh. The first thing that I will do is to run a form finding, and with only one step. I'm not really interested about the priestess or the shape of the membrane. I just want to relax the membrane to fix on these meshes. That's it. It has done the form finding. You see the geometry has changed, but still ugly. What I'm going to do now is recall the remesh tool. So I want to remesh the surface with 0.2 by 0.2. Let's make 0.25 by 0.25. That's the size of the mesh I have used when I have created the mesh. Okay. And that's it. You see now how, after relaxing it, and the mesh, the nice and smooth mesh we have got out. Maybe this one is still too small, but this is fine for the purposes. So we have a nice mesh. Let's put the UCS word. Let's give a look from top. Now, what I want to do right now is to set the warp and the weft direction for these meshes. Well, this is quite simple. I will set that my warp is in the X direction. So go here, warp weft mapping. X at the plane is warp. Okay. I do the same for all the fields. Okay. This one here. Okay. Now we can set the properties for the membrane. So we select the membranes. And we set up that these have presets 1x1 kilonewton per meter. That could be okay. And the type of membrane. The last thing that we have to do. Not really. Let's relax again this one. Just one step. And let's give a look at the membrane stresses. Point finding. I want to see, let's say, the warp stresses. Let's put in wireframe. These are the warp stresses. We can see that we have a nice 1 kilonewton per meter membrane stress. These are the weft stresses. Again, we have a nice 1 kilonewton per meter weft stresses. Okay, so the first field is done. We have done this first one, but I want to do another 3 of these fields. What we'll do now? Let me hide this tool here, hides and unhides the CAD and the FEM model. So I've just hidden the CAD model, and so I can select all the FEM elements in one shot. We go now into the CAD tools and use the tool copy to copy FEM objects. We have to pre-select, so I have pre-selected my objects. The command now is asking me to select the objects to copy. I just want to keep the selection. So you just right click or you click enter. So the start point is here. And I just go and I copy here, here, and here. That's it. Doing the copy. Of course, we have made a lot of overlapping elements. So now I want to clean this model, deleting the elements that overlap. We go into the FEM tools and we have this find overlapped. We leave the default parameters, and these are all the elements that are duplicated. So I just click on cans to delete them.